Don't be a boob. For more videos like this one, please subscribe to this channel.
Before you know it, you can't find the fire hydrant. You've got to put flags on top of your mailboxes. That happens. And we've got more snow in store here across parts of the Great Lakes and into the Northeast today with what's left of Peggy. So as we take a look at the big map today, it really kind of spells out what's going on. So what you see here, including that trailing end of that cold front, that's all from Peggy and that cold air wrapping around back behind it. And that's what's giving us our lake effect snow shower. So we still have some action going on. It's a gusty day. It's a damp day in some of these areas. And we've got the rain coming down in a place like Boston as well as into Providence. We've got snow primarily coming down into parts of Maine right now. And then you can see the winds bringing that cold air across the warmer Great Lakes and bringing those lake effect snow showers. Grand Rapids, you've been seeing it through a good portion of the day. Cleveland, some light snow showers and 23 degrees right now. And Buffalo, you've got the snow coming in and 27 degrees right now. So definitely cold enough to snow across the Great Lakes, and the winds continue to be really strong. A lot of our advisories getting set to expire now here as of the top of the hour, but still, you could have some visibility issues because of the strong winds. 37 mile per hour gusts in Detroit, Cleveland at 30 miles per hour, and look at that, Buffalo, 46 mile per hour wind gusts. So you combine that with snow, and that's going to be a rough go of it along I-81 as well as on the New York State Thruway. We've got warnings and advisories, which are in effect because of the lake effect snow showers. And in those dark blue areas, that's where we have the lake effect snow warnings, where the greatest snowfall totals are likely to occur between now and the end of the day for tomorrow. There you can see into the I-95 corridor, though, we still have that southerly flow. So you're in that warmer sector here of that storm, and that's why you're still getting more rain than anything else in a place like Boston. Albany getting a little break in the action overall. You've got a mix of sunshine and clouds and 37 degrees. And then on the tail end of the cold front, we're watching another little disturbance here, and we've got enough instability in the atmosphere that we're getting some thunderstorms. That's right, thunderstorms just north and west of the Houston metro area. The rain's been coming down here into Lake Charles and pushing towards New Orleans. So New Orleans, a heads up that the sprinkles and the light showers are going to be on the way. And then that cold front bringing some rain here into southern parts of Georgia through the Carolinas, down into northern parts of Florida. Wet weather just to your south and west here in Jacksonville. So be prepared later this afternoon. The rain's going to be a little heavier and a little bit more persistent as well. Likely only picking up maybe a quarter of an inch or so of rainfall across the region. It's not going to be super heavy across the Carolinas, but certainly enough to slow you down a little bit on the roadway. So a lot going on with the remnants of Peggy. And of course, we've got a lot more to talk about with rain, snow, and cold temperatures, Mark.